Freedom from the physical body is the answer to the lifelong invalid. Freedom from the physical body is the answer to the lifelong warrior and pessimist. On our side, we wish you could see it. The recompense, the balance, for remember, this is one of the laws of transmutation. You should be grateful for your failures, dear boy, because the longer your struggle against the negative, the longer and more powerful is the other end of the pendulum. The rhythm takes you from a long night to a long day, from a short night to a short day. A little ticking pendulum doesn't matter much, but a long swing does. And when it's past the meridian, when the negative passes the meridian, the same length, in fact a little more, because you're determined to transmute, has pushed it up farther. Go on pushing up your pendulum, dear boy. You will win.
Thank you. Moontrail, there are times when what seems to be a negative is infinitely more attractive than the positive. Take, for instance, suppose someone feeling very tired and jaded after, say, a lot of work, has a choice between, say, going for a nice, healthy, peaceful row on a river which will make them feel better and stronger for the next bash, and going round the corner to see a sick person in, well, not particularly sick, but miserable person in a dark basement who is full of misery and complaints and one thing or another. Now, one knows one ought to go and see that miserable person full of complaints, but one is going to be infinitely more exhausted after it than taking what would seem to be the negative action and going for a nice row along the river and getting better.
Yes. No. Thank you, dear child. A very, very live problem. It's really a problem within the realm of moral behavior. It's not so much a question of negative and positive application of the laws of transmutation as it is brought within the realm of the unmoral action of not facing up to the duty of rendering service to the sick person. It is therefore, it is of course, you're quite right, it is a negative and positive problem, but here again, moral values can only come in accordance with the extent of light. Now, you may think, dear child, that you would choose the river because it may be a proclivity of yours to enjoy open air and the quietude and peace of a backwater. You may think, but you wouldn't, you know, with the enlightenment within your soul, personally, you wouldn't be allowed to. Your soul, you'd say, well, I'd like to. Now, you know that we have said time and time again, the recognition of a positive is its discomfort, but that doesn't mean physical discomfort. You'd have no discomfort at your soul's center by obeying the call to service in going to the sick person. You might have it here, and that's where your discriminative faculties need sharpening the farther you travel along the road. We think that individuals must be left the choice here. What we're trying to say in a nutshell is that the person who chose the river would probably not possess sufficient soul illumination to show the difference between the negative and positive. If you can see it, you will do the right thing. Thank you. But you must see it. Yes.
Yes, Moontrail. Suppose one tried to get them both in and cut down the miserable person's time in order to get the row on the river. Would that be right?
Splendid. We would say that's typical of your earth life. The world is made up of sinners, saints, and equivocators.
Yes, sir.
Moontrail, am I right in assuming that cosmic intelligence is subjected to this law of rhythm?
Yes.
In the belief that creation comes out of this cosmic intelligence and therefore has created us and that we are part of it and subjected to the law?
Precisely, dear boy, we could not have put it more clearly than you have. Thank you, you've got the picture quite well. Holding that picture and understanding that viewpoint, you perhaps can forgive us. For sometimes in this very building, on a Sunday because it's the Sabbath and It's the day when the Anku gives come into their own. And we have watched our bombshells drop when we've answered the question, whence came evil? Where did sin come from? Where did error come from? And we've always said it's part of God. And a shudder goes through the audience. What a dreadful piece of heresy. But it must be. If night came from God and cold came from God, because it is the creative force, the cosmic creation, how can you separate it? A non-separate, all-inclusive universe must include the negatives with the positives. But so long as evil is on its way towards good, which is the supreme purpose of cosmic intelligence, who cares? Except, as we've said, the unco-good. We are told by Hu and Fo the trance of allotment. This is interesting. Since Dr. G, a beloved healing collaborator in our band, stood on his dignity, mounted his high horse and said, we have to preserve our instrument's energy, and went into conference with Hu and Fo, we've gone into the wartime habit, which you invented, of rationing the amount of trance time. We're told our ration has expired. So God bless you, good night to you, thank you, and thanks for wisdom.